So, made the first stop. We're going to remove the contents of one of the lifts and place it on here so that he can get work on it when he gets his garage door all done. But for now, this is our first stop, our first attempt to try and move the contents out of that box and then hopefully be able to get back home to my place and remove that one for myself and my garage. But hopefully we can get this done in an hour or two. Well, it took us a while to do this. Rain didn't help the fact that this thing was heavy. And didn't calculate the fact that when I did it by myself about 10 years ago, this was already on the driveway. So getting this stuff off the box truck was a nightmare. So we are starting to unload mine. So doing a little better. Hey, with Miles. Hey Miles, thank you. You gonna come help us? This is basically unloading some stuff. So we started doing it. All we have to do now is just around. It's pretty tiring. But so anyway. What? We just had a problem unloading. That's what took the time.
You got a regular soccer wrench?
Yeah, let me get it. Yeah. If you what? You better have the place clean.
Yeah, no, my room is clean.
And not just your room, everything, all the doors gotta be closed. Here. Here, this is this one doesn't swivel.
Who's got one?
Oh,
you
got
have,
one?
You had one here, we didn't know that.
I did?
Yeah, you had
one. So we're starting to unload mines. Well, so we're starting to unload mine, and it's a bit of a work like the last one, but at least it's not raining. So anyway, we got Marcus here helping us out. We got a young gun with some strength.
So, brand new knees.
Brand new knees, brand new back. I didn't get a chance to actually move these cars around, but what I'm going to end up doing is doing that tonight, see if I can maybe do some shifting. A couple of guys are going to be coming over today as well to give me a hand, so maybe we can do that. Anyway, so, so I'll go ahead and continue this as we're trying to make use of the daylight. So I got all the items for the lift unloaded thanks to Atu, Nate, my son, and Marcus. That was a bit of a chore, but the second time around was actually much better and much quicker. So just a matter of me just shuffling these cars around. I might try to do it this evening, but it might be too loud for the neighbors, but we'll see. And see if I can maybe at least get it to a point where all I have to do tomorrow is assembly. So it's the following morning and it's raining. Hopefully there's no hail. And we are going to shift these cars around and get the build started for the lift. So you guys are going to have to forgive me. Garage is a mess right now just because of the fact that I'm kind of shifting a lot of stuff around to make room for that lift. Some of my suey parts got wet because I had the garage door open when I got through some torrential downpour. But anyway, I was able to get the Supra in and the Arc 7 on the lift temporarily. The hydraulics isn't completed yet, but anyway, thanks to Kevin and Don for helping me finish up the last leg of the mechanical portion of the lift. So, several days later, I made the mistake. Whoops, what is that? So, a couple days later, I made the mistake of actually situating the entire lift to where it was going to be. It was cool to get to test the car on it and just to get it situated and looking nice. But the problem was, which I didn't take into consideration, is the fact that this lever that unlocks the lift from the safety, unlocks the platform from the safety, needs to go into this hole. Where is it? It's right here. You probably guys can't see it because the lighting here is bad. But of course, there is no room to insert that long pole. What they should have done is they should have put a collar here, just like they have on that one, just so that they can insert it without having to have this entire assembly further back, so that you can insert that entire length of pole through here. But yeah, so I had to move this with the use of a jack engine hoist to lift this entire thing further back, just so that I can scoop that lever or that pole over to that slot. So DFD is going to have to go back out a little further, and for me to be able to get that pole in. So that kind of sucks, but at least I got the cables in. That was a little trying, but wasn't too bad because this was on the floor. I had to use the hoist to get up so that I can get the cables that was routed and zip tied on this platform. So I was able to kind of maneuver my way. Just I lifted it about maybe half a foot, got myself on my arms underneath to pull out the cables and unzip tie them and pull them and attach them with where they're supposed to be. So this is certainly doable if you were to do it on your own. If you have the hoist and the jack and some casters. The problem that we had was we didn't remove all the items, the heavy items that was on the ramp that had the cylinder in it, the hydraulic cylinder. So that kind of made it a little tough. And the fact that we had to unload it from the box truck to the driveway. When I did it by myself back in, 2001, the entire assembly was on the driveway, so I was able to use my hoist, my jack, and some casters to be able to wheel it out as soon as I unpack the boxes and situate them in my garage. So it took a little time, but definitely doable on your own. But I don't suggest it, just simply because it'll go faster. So what I'm using now to get to move this is the casters that came with the lift. So I'm going to be shifting it far enough just so that I can get the pole in. So anyway, alright, so I'll get back on it. So she's all done. Hours later, I made some mistakes in that I had forgotten a lock nut on the safety latch, and I was having a difficult time trying to get the lift down when I tested it. I didn't want to go through the whole how-to. There's a lot of how-to on setting this lift up. So I decided to just kind of just get it going, get it done. The other issue that I ran into was I had forgotten to, well, not really forgotten, I didn't tighten it enough, one of the fittings for the hydraulics. So, unfortunately, if you guys can tell, I mean, the lighting here is bad. I haven't really done anything to lighting. I had to remove a light bulb just so that I can clear. Well, I just want to make sure it does clear. But I definitely do have like a foot of space up top and another foot down here. So I definitely can fit the R33 and the STI down here. So if you can tell, probably can't, but there's a lot of spillage on the floor, a lot of paper towels. You can tell from this bucket right here. I must have lost maybe probably a gallon worth of hydraulic fluid. So lessons learned, but she's up and running. Kind of miss having a lift. So finally got one. It's been, what, 6-7 years since my old lift in my old house. So I kind of got spoiled with that. But anyway, so I'll probably see if I can try to get a better video of the setup in the daylight, because right now the lighting, like I said, isn't up to par. I need to get some lighting done, and yeah, I now have a free bay to be able to do some work and maybe to put in some stuff and get the stand going with the IAG block for the STI. So and those are the heads for it. Good morning, guys. Today is Sunday, the day after, or the day before, I should say, Labor Day. We're going to go head over to Atu's garage. He's the other guy that got the other lift, as you guys saw in the video, previous video, or it could be this video, I'm not quite sure. I never know how I'm going to edit these things, but anyway, so we're going to try and help him assemble his. We're not going to go through the whole process, but just maybe do a quick video before and after. He's the guy with the two FDs, and let's go ahead and head over to his lair. This truck needs some cleaning.